hardworking, problem-solving, interpersonal communication, and possess leadership qualities. The great mentors warmly welcome Ms. Chandrakala Mishra, Principal, Abhay International School. She believes in transformative leadership wherein effectively collaboration with all levels of staff members and establishment of quality relationships, administrative abilities and strong believer of mutually respectful relationship with staff members and students. She is well versed with ICSE affiliation and documentations process, heading all administrative, academics and functional responsibilities, hiring, evaluating and providing training to teachers, administrative and support staff. She has been awarded with prestigious awards, Nari Tu Narayani, Guru Dronacharya Award.
Hello friends. A hardworking, problem-solving, interpersonal communication and possess leadership qualities. She believes in transformative leadership, wherein effectively collaboration with all levels of staff members and establishment of quality relationships, administrative abilities and strong believer of mutually respectful relationship with staff members and students. On behalf of the great mentors, me, Sushil Sinha, warmly welcomes Ms. Chandrakala Mishra ma'am for today's talk show session. Thanks, ma'am, for giving your valuable time and being with us. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Very good afternoon, Sushil ji. Thank you, the mentor team.
First, we would like to know about your professional journey up till this point. Please share that.
The opportunity to speak here.
Please share your professional journey up till now.
I started my journey in 1989 with the class 5 class teachership. School was in Sion. It was very wonderful experience. I was very young, 22-year-old girl, with lot of curiosity to do something in the classroom. Even some of my seniors used to get irritated with me, ki why she is so curious. But again, you know, I wanted to do something with the student apart from just teaching, just to give them some opportunity to speak, express, and be a very, very reliable member of the society, which I still believe that a student is a future member of society. So as modify them in a way where they can contribute to the society, they should return to the society what society is giving them in the form of facilities and other perks.
So you started as a teacher, right? And right now you are a principal of Abhay International School.
Yes, sir.
There are many milestones to go ahead for you. We wish us the best for you in upcoming years. Ma'am, you much focus about on administration. How do you do this?
Sir, I began myself as a teacher, then I promoted as a lecturer in D8 college, then a professor in B8 college. And somewhere I felt that teachers work very diligently if given them proper guidance, if given them proper administration. And when I started working as a coordinator, academic coordinator, I saw that I can manage things very well. I was good in managing people. So I developed that quality. I try to see the psychology of the teacher, psychology of the children, how they work, what are their mental conditions. And somewhere I got a hold there and I felt this is the area where I will work. Even I'm doing my PhD and my topic is teachers' professional development, keeping in their mental status also. How they go through different situations when they are teaching in pandemic, non-pandemic, and how they want to grow professionally. So some I feel that teachers are core of education. We say that technology will replace teachers, but I don't believe in that. Technology can never replace teachers. They can supplement teacher. Teacher can be more powerful with the help of technology, but the mentorship which a teacher is doing, no robot, no technology, no e-technology can replace too. Teachers are the best, you can say, the second parent for the children, which they trust, they learn, and they carry the knowledge with them. So I believe that I should work in the administration to to give them more power to understand their problem, to make the transaction smoother. That is the only intention behind administration.
This is really very true. Emotion cannot be produced from machine or robot from any of the digital devices. So human behavior, human touch, that is the must, and that's the prime. Teachers are always there. They are second parent of children.
That's true.
And that cannot be replaced by any kind of machine.
No.
When they talk with the children, when they give emotion to the children, that gives entire different feeling to their students, and that promoted them, that motivated them to do something different in their life.
That's true, sir. Teachers put lot of long impression, maybe bad or good, on child's mentality. So teachers play very crucial role. Even I remember my teachers who taught me maths, which I was very fearful of. My favorite Marathi teacher, because she was very motherly figure. Definitely that impressed me to be like that teacher and do not like that teacher. We bifurcate them on the basis of their quality. So I always tell my teachers, be very friendly, but draw a line between that. You should not be too close. But again, you are role models. So the way you dress, the way you speak, the way you deliver the lecture, it is very important. So you may be having more knowledge or less knowledge. That can be increased by reading books, by reading extra material. But the compassion, the professional devotion you are having, that no one can take you from you. That is your uniqueness. That separates you from other teacher. And that is why you get so many cards, which principal never gets on Teacher's Day. But teachers get many cards on Teacher's Day. I get single one or two cards. Being principal, maybe they are frightened of me. I don't know.
Really, very, very true. You, ma'am, you also very much focused about creativity of classes.
Yes.
Can you suggest how to create this part, classroom creativity, please?
Sushilji, classroom should not be boring. When we say that teachers should teach in the classroom, we tell them to prepare the lesson plan well in advance. But again, I feel class is a heterogeneous group. Once you start your lecture, as per the response, your plan should bit modify here and there. Suppose I have planned the activity, but again, I see that response is not there. Immediately, I should add activity where teaching students can respond to me. I should not go systematically, chalo ye plan kiya hai, to aise hi padhana hai because someone is observing me. Nothing like that. My teachers are very much free. If I am sitting in their classroom for observation and students are not in a mood of teaching, studying, don't teach. Play some kind of game, have some kind of discussion. Because teaching, surely teaching is required, but again, student engagement is equally important. So my classrooms are creative. Teachers conduct many activities. We play sports for the maths class. Will you believe it? So this is the creative which they do. They play football for maths class. For the music class, they are reading maths book. Like vice versa. Because all the subjects are correlated. If you plan properly, if you design it properly, keeping in mind the chapters in other two subjects, English and history can be combined. So classroom can be creative. Creativity doesn't mean you have to bring many videos, PPTs and all. Your activity should be such that child should feel motivated to participate. The child who is not speaking, who is scoring less, the child should also feel that, oh, I have contributed one sentence in the discussion, and which is very important.
Involvement of child, that is very much required in their development and in their learning process. So I think you more focus to the involvement of the children.
Yes.
And I think it's also a part of STEM.
Yes.
Right. In each and every subject, there is some creativity, and how they are going to deal with that. History doesn't mean that the only numbers and years are there. A lot of things are related with that. How they are correlating the things, that is very much important. And I think you are more focused on that part.
True, very true. History looks like a boring subject. But when I used to teach history, I used to create the characters in the classroom. Children used to play the part of the character. The reason behind that, I should not get angry with the particular character because he is or she is formed in the villain form. I should know the reason behind that. When we teach English, we do character sketching, where each character is sketched by the character is behaving in a particular way. So here we need to make student understand that the particular character is behaving due to particular situation.
Correct.
In real life also it happens. We categorize people, he is bad, he is good, he is different. So child should understand that no one is good and bad, everyone is behaving as per the situation provided. So whether it is history, whether it is English, my classrooms were full of noises. I used to get lot of scolding from my principal ma'am also. Why so much noise in your class? But again, classroom should be noisy. Children should be able to speak in the classroom. They should not be sitting at one corner and listening to your lecture, that boring lecture. They should be able to move from their place. They should participate. They should discuss. They should give wrong answer and you should correct them with the right statement. Then only they will be confident in you, yet my teacher is good. You are having less knowledge, they will not bother. But you are having correct knowledge, you understand them, that is very important. So teachers are very, very important when they do it positively with the student. Their attitude is very important, how they behave with the student in the classroom.
And that's the reason you all always focus on professional development of teachers, right?
Yes.
So how this process is you used to do, and what are the suggestions from your side to the other principals and other teachers to go in this process as a professional development and also as professional behavior?
See, to be very frank, one statement which I use in all my interviews that I believe in parallel leadership, where all are leaders. All are decision makers. So whatever is my decision, I sit with them, I discuss with them, I see all the pros and cons, then I take decision. Because we all may be a bit of position here and there, but we all are in a position to take decision when we are unanimously taking the decision for the student's benefit. For the professional development, I engage them in different training program, which is approved by management. I conduct training program for them, for their personality development, how to write emails, what are the career options available to them, whether you have joined LinkedIn or not, are you away from Facebook and new Facebook you are joining LinkedIn, so many platforms where you can grow professionally, many free courses are available, are you aware of that or not? Because you cannot stagnate them just for your benefit. If they have wings, let them fly. Let them fly, let them grow. That growth will reflect in your school's progress. If they want to fly and go away on another branch, that is perfectly fine. But at least that person will be happy that he or she got the right kind of guidance from you. And then definitely they will grow and they will be the next leader. You will feel happy you created one more leader under your guidance, parallel your guidance. I don't know. Under, I cannot say because I am also learning with them. So we all are leader in my school. Maybe just my chair is different, their chair is different. That's it.
Great, ma'am. And actually, the leadership is to empower others.
Yes.
The true leadership
someone
is...
Someone empowered me, so I am sitting here. So I should empower others.
Yes.
And others also join as a leaders.
Very true. What are the challenges you faced during this digital devices era? When students are... using that.
Many challenges. My school, when I joined 6 years back, my school 11-year-old school, when I joined 6 years back, there was challenge. There was hiccups with the parent. My principal ma'am joined, I joined, and then new principal, new books, we don't want this, we don't want this. There was restriction for everything. They don't want any system which we were trying to create. But again, with the phase of time when they saw that we are doing better for their student, we are giving new technologies, we are using new things, we are using system for their kids, there was improvement in their children's behavior, marks, their personality. So they believed in us. Now my parents are my core strength. They believe in me, they believe in my team. And my children believe in me. So all the 750 students, I am their mother, they are my kid, and we focus purely on their development. I never believe in marks funda. Please don't tell your children to score 90%, 100%. Let the child score 40%, but child should be happy with the way he or she is growing. Because what happens in the competition of marks, somewhere the base quality of the child is good in music, dance, or in, I tell my parents, if the child is in 10th standard, so he should not participate in dance, should not participate in music, why so? It should not be the same. Now new technology is coming, so children are totally hooked with the studies. But ultimately that 10th standard marks will not that much matter. But again, the career they are choosing, the options they are choosing will matter. So let them give free atmosphere to choose their best for them. We are there to guide them. So I believe students should be guided properly, given proper mentoring. So in my school, we don't call my teachers teachers. They are mentors because they are facilitators. They just facilitate the student because knowledge is everywhere spread due to Google. But right kind of knowledge to be provided by the facilitator, which my teachers do the best with the given facility by the management.
How to get good marks? It is very easy to learn the students, but how to be happy? That is the most important part, and you are focusing on that part. Very few people I met by this time, they learn the child in this way. It's a really a great initiative, ma'am. From just a minute. Thanks for your initiative, ma'am. You are really doing great job. Preparing for marks, that's very easy, but keeping the child and preparing them to get happiness, that is very much important. It's going to be a unique thing for their life. Life has different dimensions, sometimes good, sometimes bad, but keeping themselves happy, it's really a great job. Ma'am, our another question is, what do you think, how technology is going to play its role in this era of education?
Technology is important. We are in the era where we cannot escape technology. We cannot say that the conventional method which my teacher was teaching, this is best, or my teachers are doing best. So when the pandemic began on 22nd of March, the first question on every principal was how to run the school. Even I was worried how to train my 40 teachers and how to begin the school. So first I took Zoom meeting. So my teachers were hesitant, ma'am, my number will go to parent, ma'am, how I will look, ma'am, how my voice will go. I said, let us give it a try. Daily, half an hour we used to teach each other on Zoom so that we can be comfortable. And within 15 days, you will not believe, my 54-year-old teacher from my 20-year teachers all were ready with the lessons, all were ready with the presentation. In the classroom, they teach orally, but during online lectures, they were ready with many PPTs. My heart was so felt proud that, oh my goodness, just a little push and they can show their best. So that is why I believe that teachers are my strong strength. They are my backbones. So technology is important, very important, but again, it should be blended. We should not totally be dependent on technology. Internet is not there, not there, so no lecture. Oh, my presentation, I forgot the pen drive at home. No, not at all. Everything should be in your mind also. If it is in the form of technology, it will be better. Technology will help us to make our work easier. Notes can be typed and shown in the PPT form. Then many activities, now this augmentation is going on. We can show them. Many live example, simulated situations can be shown through the technology, which will make teachers work a bit lighter and explaining will be more easier. So technology will definitely add the quality of teacher and it will be helpful. So I believe each teacher should know the as many technology which is available. I always search for the new technology. I send the link to my teacher, please check. Anything can be useful for you. Don't go with the traditional method of lecturing, giving worksheet, giving marks, finish. No. Sometimes pure discussion can be your judgment. You can judge the student purely on the basis of their classroom behavior. When you're teaching, how they are behaving, how they are reacting. So sometimes they may speak wrong English, sometimes they may interpret wrong, but at least they are trying. It means they are trying to listen to you. So technology is boom if you use properly. So use it properly and take the advantage of that and add to your feather. Many new certificate courses are there, many new things are there which you can learn, and you can it will help you to grow as a teacher. So teachers should always learn something or other thing. It is noble profession. I am teaching and delivering my lecture. I am coming back to home. I am at peace. No more peace. Now, no job is a noble job unless you're giving your 100%, unless you're learning the new technology, unless you're improving your quality. See, stagnated water also start like getting smell. So don't be a stagnated water, be a flow of river. Always new things should flow. So student will be impressed with you. They will be happy to learn something from you. Whenever I used to teach in my classroom and I was teaching, they used to put me the question, I used to say, kal bataungi, because mujhe nahi aata hai. So what will happen? Oh, it means teacher also don't know. It means you are normal. So this kind of things will happen, and you should not be hesitant. Oh, I don't know. So my big insult will happen. No, nothing like that. You can come next day with bigger answers, with a lot of explanation, and they will feel happy. Oh, my questions are answered by my teacher. She kept me in mind and she prepared for me. So just be very close to your student, see the individual differences among the student. The most notorious student should be given more attention in the classroom, given more responsibility in the classroom, tell them to guide the classroom, tell them to lead the classroom, and their mischievousness will turn into leadership. They will be more focused to show the talent, and then they will forget to trouble others. The way they are troubling others, they will start leading others. They will start giving advices to others. So I always believe there is always positivity in each negativity if diverted properly. So divert that. Teacher should be mentally strong. When you enter the gate, kindly keep your home problem outside the gate. When you go outside the gate, kindly leave the schoolwork in the school and be with your family. But make a balance. Make a balance, give your best when you're working, give your best when you're at home. But again, we are educator, we are not working in 9-to-5 job ki aaj ka file pending hai to kal kar lenge. No, we have to plan such a way that students' growth, development, their mental health, their behavior, their social behavior should modify with the example of us. They should look us as an example. So, which is very important. So, teachers wear multiple hats, and hats off to them for that. We are sitting in one chair, we are looking after the things, but they go in different classrooms, different students, but again, the same love, same compassion, the same kind of energy they put in the lecture. So, teachers, do your best. As an administrator, we can always help you, but again, you are the backbone, you are the best part, which your school
have. It's a really great one. You are not giving happiness to the children. You must be empowering your teacher staff as well. One thing is very much sure, because the way you the way we observed how you are treating the things, how you are performing and how you are executing the things, it's definitely going to improve them a lot. In fact, it's going to empower them a lot. They are lucky to have you as a principal of that school. They also must be very proud of you.
I am lucky because I have so strong team that I can sit and I can speak confidently.
Yes.
Otherwise, if they are not working properly, I will be always in trouble. So my team is really strong, very helpful, very dedicated. If I will tell them to do X, they will do X, Y, Z. They are great. So advanced. I'm very happy with them. And we work as a team, Sushil ji. We never work as a boss and subordinate, something like that. We sit together, we discuss everything under sun, which can be possible for both the sides. My parents, my backbone, my students are my strength, and my teachers are my power. So I am powerful because of that. But again, it is the combined effort of everyone.
This is a positive reflection of your leadership, ma'am. How their team is going to behave, it depends on their team lead. How these leaders are behaving, that is very much important. And why you are happy, because of your character, how and your behavior towards your down the line. You are really, you really reflect a true leadership quality. It's really, really great. Thanks for that. From the students and staff side.
Thank you, Sushilji.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving your valuable time and being with us. And we will try to be in touch with you with so many our upcoming events in our panel discussion and for other activities.
Sushilji, thank you very much. Thank you, the team mentor. Very, very obliged that you gave me the opportunity. Mostly, I avoid this kind of, because I believe still I'm learning phase. But again, you all gave me the confidence that yes, I am leading properly. Thank you very much for believing in me. Still learning, still in the learning phase. But again, whatever my contribution in the society, till my last breath, I am going to return to the society, because society gave me a lot. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am.